Hello and welcome to the Edupedia World. In this tutorial, we'll be learning about strings in Java. So let's begin. String class. So there are some important facts about string class. An object of string class represents a string of characters. A string class belongs to java.lang package, which does not require an import statement, so it by default get imported in your program. Like other classes, string has constructor and methods. Unlike other classes, string has two operators. One is plus and other is plus equals to, which is used for concatenation. Literal strings are anonymous object of string class, are defined by enclosing text in double quotes. For example, this is literal string. They don't have to be constructed. They can be assigned to a string variable. They can be passed to a method or a constructor as a parameter. They have methods that you can call. So these are examples of some of the literal strings. You can see we are having a string name, and the string literal that we have given is Robert. So the name over here is a variable and Robert is actually the string literal. Again, calling a method of a literal string. So there is a string literal Robert and we are calling a method on it. We are actually fetching the character at 0th index using caret. Using the variable name, we can also fetch the 0th character using name.caret 0. So this will also give us first initial character. Immutability. So string once created cannot be changed. None of its methods change the string. So the objects of string are actually immutable. So that means once created they cannot be changed. Immutable objects are convenient because several references can point to the same object safely. There is no danger of changing an object through one reference without the other being aware of the change. So since immutable object cannot be changed, so multiple references can point to same, safely. If even once tries to, change a reference, then the actual object won't get changed. Instead of that, new string literal is actually formed. So we'll see how that is done. So you can see the advantage of immutability over here. We actually tend to use less memory. Where we are having in on the left hand side, where we have having the string word 1 and the value given is Java. So Java over here is a string literal, and then we have string word 2 and we are assigning word 2 to word. So you can see in a memory only one object or a one string literal is created, that is Java, and word is assigning to that. Then we have another string variable which is word 2, and word 2 is assigning to again Java. So you can see a one string literal is created in memory, which is Java, and two objects, that is word 1 and word 2, are created, which are assigned to the Java. Okay, and on the right hand side you can see again we are having string word 1 equals to Java, so it's like a string constant is created Java, but then we are creating string word 2 using new string word 1. So that means word 2 will create new memory objects. So it will create a new object on its own because we have used new string. And then the value that we are getting is to word 1. So the value of word 1 will be copied into a new memory location and it will be assigned to word 2. So this is less efficient, and in this case we are actually wasting the memory. Okay. So what are the disadvantages of immutability? Well, you need to create new string and throw away the old one even if for a small change. So you see, when we have created a word Java and then you want to, change the first character to the uppercase. So you want to change J to uppercase. So even if you do try to do that, then a new string will be created with the name Java J with the uppercase, and the older string will lose the reference to the word Java, but it will still be there in the memory. Although later on it might be collected using garbage collection, but whenever you do any small change, a new string gets actually created. So you see, when we are having a string word Java and Then you are fetching the first character by changing it to the upper case and adding it to the word substring 1 and reassigning it to word. Then in memory, actually, the new Java is created with the uppercase J. So this is a disadvantage. Okay, so what is empty string? An empty string has no characters, its length is 0. For example, string word equals to, and you are not assigning anything just by putting an empty quotes, or string word 2 where you are assigning it to new string. These two are empty strings. Okay, so these are not same as uninitialized string. Uninitialized string is something like this. Private string error message. So over here error message is null. So there is a difference between a null string and a string with length 0 or having nothing in it. Okay. Then no argument constructor. No argument constructor creates an empty string and it's rarely used. A more common approach is to reassign a variable to it. So you can see over here we are doing string empty equals to new string, and the variable that we are used to store the input. So over here we are actually not passing any value, so it will be actually an empty string if we are not passing any value within the parenthesis of new string. Or you can even do this like that. Okay. So basically in this case you are actually calling the no argument constructor of a class string. So let's see what about copy constructor. Copy constructor creates a copy of existing string, also rarely used. It is not same as assignment. So you can see in copy constructor each variable points to different copy of a string. So first one, the word is assigned to Java, and then we have word 2. Although we are assigning it to word, but since we are using new string, so it will create a new object, and it will create a new object with the same string literal. So there will be two Java in the memory, and one is being assigned to a word and other is being assigned to word 2. Okay, so that's the purpose of copy constructor. Although it copies the value, but it will create a new object. Okay, but if we do assigning, so assigning is like this. Okay, so this is an example of assigning, and in this you can see only one Java is created and both are assigned to the same. So it's a difference between copying through a copy constructor and simply assigning it. Okay, so we do have more constructors of string. So one example is this, where we are inputting the character string, character array to new string. So this is one of the example of constructor of string. We can do even that, or we can simply write the string value over here instead of letter. So we do have different type of string constructor. Okay, now let's study some of the methods in string class. So the first method is length. So it says int length and it will return the number of characters in a string. The second one is charAt. It will actually give you the character at particular index of I. So it returns the charAt position I. The character position in string are numbers starting from 0, just like array. So if you are trying to do charAt 1, so it will actually give you the second character because it is starting from 0. Okay. So let's guess what will be the output of this problem.length. So you can see it's starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Although it is having 6 index, but the length will be 7. And charAt 2 will give you n. Okay. So you can see this is the output. Again, an important method is substring. So substring basically returns a new string by copying character from existing string. So whenever we do string subs equals to word dot substring I dot k, so it actually picks up the character from the charAt index, which is I, and till k, and it will return the substring of character in a position from I to k minus 1. Then we have string subs. So again, you can see if we are just putting the substring I, then it will start from the length I, and it will take the string till the last character. So it returns the substring from ith to charAt end. So just guess the output of this. So we are having television 2 to 5, and then immutable substring 2 and bob substring 9. Okay, another, there is a method of concatenation. So you can see over here we are having string word. Word 1 equals to re and word 2 equals to think. Then we have word 3 which is equals to ing. Then we are having int num equals to 2. Okay, after that we are having string result equals to word 1 plus word 2. So it is actually concatenating two string, that is re and think. So the output that I get in result will be rethink. Similarly, you can also do this by using a concat operation. So I can even use dot concat and pass word 2 in it. It will also give me the same output. Or I can also use plus equals to operation for that, like this as shown in these two examples. Fine. So let's move forward. Okay, another important method of string class is find index of. So using this we can actually find something. So index of is the method. So if we do date dot find index of p, so it will actually give us the index of p. Similar thing can be done for e, and similar thing can be done for George. Then over here we are having e3, and then it will going to start the searching from position 3 over here. So it will going to start the searching of e, but from the position 3. Then if we do index of Bob and Bob is not present, it will give me minus 1. You can also use last index of to get the last index of e, which will give you 15 over here. Then we have methods for equality, which is the equal method and equal ignore case method, where equal method actually compares the value. So if you do word 1 equals word 2, it will return your boolean value. It will return you true if these two are actually equal from the value perspective. Equal ignore case will also match the value by ignoring the cases. So it will return true if string word 1 matches word 2 case blind. Okay, so in this example you can see raiders equals raiders true. But over here raiders equals raiders will give you false, because r over here is in lowercase. But if you use ignore case with the same thing, it will give you true. Fine, so this is how you use equals and equals ignore case. Okay, now let's see the comparison operators. In comparison operator we are having int def, and then we are having word 1 dot compare to word 2. Over here you can see we are using return the difference word 1 minus word 2. So if you do compare 2, it is actually returning you the difference between word 1 minus word 2. Similarly, if you try to do ignore case, then after ignoring the case, I mean it will just take small r or r in a lower case or r in upper case as same, and then will let you know the difference between word 1 and word 2. So usually programmer don't care what numerical difference of word 1 and word 2 is, because actually we are doing to compare. Okay, just whether difference is negative, that means word 1 comes before word 2. 0 means word 1 is equal to word 2, and positive means word 1 comes after word 2. Okay, so that is the reason often it is used in conditional statement. For example, if word 1 compares to word 2 is greater than 0. If it's greater than 0 means positive. That means word 1 comes before word 2. Then do this, otherwise do that. So we actually usually don't care about the numerical value, but just care about its positive, negative or 0. So this is a comparison. Over here you can see we are comparing apple compared to berry. So over here you can see A comes before B, so therefore it will give you, since first one is positive, word 1 comes after word 2, this will give you negative. Okay, then we have zebra, and over here, so these are negative comparison. This will give you all negative value, because over here the first one actually is coming, you know, before A. So over here Z comes before A, over here I comes before U. So it is actually going to compare all the characters. So you can see it will compare D with D. After that it will compare I with U. Over here I comes before U, negative. Similarly over here it will compare dig with digs. Over here you can see DIG is compared to DIG, but then S is left, and since DIG is shorter, that's why it gives us negative differences. This will give us the same differences, and these will give us a positive differences. Another important method in string class is trim. So you can see we are having string word2 equals to word1.trim. So it will return the new string formed by word 1 by removing the white spaces from both ends. So if I'm using hi Bob, the output it will give me is hi Bob but without spaces. So if I use word 2 equals to word 1 dot trim, then word 2 will become hi Bob and no spaces on either end. So it will remove space from here and it will remove space from here. Whereas word 1 will still remain as hi Bob with the space. Okay. Another method is replace. So replace is actually used to replace one of a character with other character. So here you can see in an example we have a word rare, and in rare we are replacing R with D. So this will become DADE. Okay. But word 1 will still remain as rare, but word 2 will become as DADE. I hope so. This is clear. Then we can use two uppercase and two lowercase to change the cases of the word as shown in this example. So you can see over here, since string are immutable, so when I'm doing word 1 dot uppercase, word 1 will remain unimpacted, whereas the new value will get assigned to word 2. Okay. So these are replacement, where you can see we are using an example in this. We are converting word 1 to uppercase and replace the references with the new reference. So when we change the word 1 to uppercase, then we are assigning back it to word 1. Okay. So using this, it will change the word 1 value. But if we simply do this, this won't change the word 1 value. Okay, now how to convert numbers to string? Well, we can do that using simple string concatenation by concatenating a empty value, empty string literal to the integer. It will give us a string. Or I can even use integer dot toString. Similarly, I have double dot toString. So this will actually give me string literal. Then we have a value called string dot value of, and passing integer in that will give us again a string literal. Fine. So these are three methods for converting number to string. Well, over here, integer and double are wrapper classes and they are present in java.lang, and they represent numbers as objects. So over here you see integer is actually a wrapper class and this class is having a method toString to convert. Similarly, double is also a wrapper class. So what are wrapper class? We study in detail. For now, just consider them as a normal class, okay, which is having a method toString to convert double to string. And integer is a wrapper class for int, which is having a method to convert integer to string. Okay guys, so now we have reached to string buffer. So two more important topics are left in string. One is string buffer and other is string builder. So we'll be covering them in next video. As of now, I would like to pause this video and I won't like to stretch it further. So thank you guys. As of now, stay tuned and let's meet in the next tutorial.